Hi there, thanks for tuning in to Dear Sybersue. I'm Susan McCord. Today's topic is, are you emotionally connected to your partner? If you're planning on having a long-term relationship with somebody, there's certain things that need to be at par with each other when you're in a relationship. If you're not on the same emotional page as your partner, there's always going to be some kind of upset that happens because emotions go into everything. It goes into your sex life. It goes into how you view life and how passionate you are about certain goals and achievements you want to happen within your own life. And also how your partner and you get along when it comes to anything that you are excited about. Like, everyone thinks emotional connection is just basically about the bedroom. Well, that's a huge part of it for sure, because if you're not on the same emotional level with your partner, the bedroom is going to be a little bit different in how you interact, literally, with each other. You might be more of the hand-holding type, you know, want to do a lot more kissing and all those kind of things, and your partner's basically, get in here, get it done, and let's go kind of thing. And then you're sitting here going, well, I didn't really feel very connected to them. And so this is where it can become a huge problem. Being emotionally connected to your partner will keep you together for a long time, because you both see things in a romantic sense. You've got energy about certain things and passion about certain things in life. And you can visualize things at the same pace together. If one person is more detached, eventually it's going to cause a detachment in your relationship. What happens, you either tone down to their level of not being excited about anything, or you go the opposite and start pulling away and finding it somewhere else outside of your home. This is where it gets dangerous. And this is why emotional attachment should be very similar with each other when you're planning on having a future together. Because it's a big one. It's a huge one to keep your relationship in an exciting place. When you've got passion and energy about anything in an emotional sense, and you're on the same page with each other, it just keeps things flowing. It's really great to have that in your relationship, because you both look at things the same way. There's no reason that you guys can't talk about this in the beginning and try to find some kind of scenario that can make it work. But if you're too different and somebody is just so closed off, you're not going to reach them unless they maybe get some professional help or some counseling about it, because you're asking them to be somebody they're not. Now, that could just be a personality trait, or it could be something that they have got into themselves over the years of maybe a really difficult childhood where there wasn't any love at home, so they don't really know what it is. Or it could have been like a really difficult breakup and they've never got over it. They don't trust again. They've shut down their feelings. They've got a Berlin Wall around them. But it's not your job to try and bring that wall down so that you can come in and help them through it all. You can be there for them and try to understand it. But if they're not willing to go and get some help for it, it's going to be, as I said earlier, a one-sided scenario. So being sort of in a robotic way of just sort of existing will not sustain the longevity in your partnership. So if somebody's upset that you're not being as emotional as they want you to be, you might want to listen a little bit here, because you are in a relationship with them. You fell in love with them for a reason. There's something about them that made you want to be with them. So you need to do everything in your power to try and keep your relationship growing and evolving. And if you're shut down and they're chipping away all the time at you to get you to open up, it becomes a really, really difficult job for the person trying to get you to open up. And eventually you're going to get frustrated too, because you're having to do something that isn't in your normal way of doing things. It's not your normal character. So please make sure you're on the same page when you're dating somebody in the beginning, that you're both deep thinkers, you can talk about anything, you've got very similar personalities. This kind of stuff is really, really good to have when you're first starting out to see if you can make it long term. Because it's the simple things in a relationship that actually make the relationship. But if you don't have that foundation in the early stages, attraction and excitement in the first couple of months isn't going to be enough to maintain a long and healthy relationship. Maybe you're just different people. Maybe there's just something that's stuck, and maybe something can be fixed to keep the relationship strong between the two of you. So thanks for tuning in to Dear Sybersue. Please subscribe to my channel here on YouTube if you haven't already done so. Check out my blogs and advice column on sybersue.com and leave your comments below the video, and please like the video. Thanks so much. Take care. Bye.